When my parents were about to become parents, they had the talk. Would they be a bilingual household or an English-only household? My mom fought hard for English-only, and she won. Today's generation of Latinos seem mostly bilingual. The U.S. system of education continues to meet the needs of its Spanish-speaking students with ESL teachers and the like. Still, Latinos lag behind in number of degrees earned when compared with all other groups. However, Pew Research Center, Hispanic trend statistics have been showing an upward trend, but we have a ways to go. Why mention statistics? Because more often than not, a college degree is the surest ticket to middle class benefits. Do I regret not knowing Spanish? Do I regret not growing up amongst Latinos? Do I regret not being a first generation Mexican American? Most of the time, no. I have two master's degrees, so I enjoy the middle class life of a tenured community college professor. But sometimes, yes. When Latinos are speaking Spanish and I can't understand what they're saying or join in. And sometimes, yes. When I notice how comfortable Latinos are with each other, which I attribute to them growing up immersed in Latino culture. And yes, when I am introduced to mujerista theology from a white woman at my mostly white church. And especially, yes, when I'm feeling fully Mexican inside my skin and a fellow Latino asked to see my Latino membership card. Thank you.
Come and join us on a praise to the Lord. when the people of the Lord saw Moses, delayed to come down from the mountain. The people gathered around Aaron and said to him, "Come, make gods for us. Who shall go before us? As for this Moses, the man who brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we do not know what has become of him." Aaron said to them, "Take off the gold rings that are on the ears of your wives, your sons, and your daughters, and bring them to me." So all the people took off the gold rings from their ears and brought them to Aaron. He took the gold from them, formed it in mold, and cast an image of a calf. And they said, "These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt." When Aaron saw this, he built an altar before it. And Aaron made a proclamation and said, "Tomorrow shall be a festival to the Lord." They rose early the next day and offered burnt offerings and brought sacrifices of well-being. And the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to revel. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once. Your people whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt have acted perversely. They have been quick to turn aside from the way that I commanded them. They have cast for themselves an image of a calf and have worshipped it and sacrificed to it and said, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord said to Moses, "I have seen this people, how stiff-necked they are. Now let me alone so that my wrath may burn hot against them and I may consume them, and of you I will make a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord, his God, and said, "O Lord, why does your wrath burn hot against your people, whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt with great power and with mighty hand? Why should the Egyptians say, 'It was with evil intent that he brought them up out to kill them in the mountains and to consume them from the face of the earth'? Turn from your fierce wrath, change your mind, and do not bring disaster on your people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, how you swore to them by your own self, saying to them, 'I will multiply your descendants like the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have promised, I will give to your descendants, and they shall inherit it forever.' And the Lord changed his mind about the disaster that he planned to bring on his people." A word of God for the people of God.
Christ, he requires still, wheresoe'er he comes, to feed or lodge, to have the best of rooms. Give him the choice. Grant him the nobler part of all the house. The best of all is the heart.
Thank you. So were you listening? Were you listening to that interaction between Moses and God? Did you hear God being kind of, oh, I don't know, copying an attitude? Did you hear that? Go away, Moses, I'm on a stew here. Did you hear that? I love it. We get in this story more of that intimate relationship between Moses and God. It's an intimacy that allows the dialogue to be just real, right? Just how it might be if you're sitting over breakfast with your husband or your wife or your son or your daughter or your partner, someone you're sitting over the table with, at the table with on a regular basis. And they say something that you just don't feel so good about. And rather than thinking about your response, you kind of go, huh? And you might put a few words in there that we're not going to repeat in the sanctuary. Maybe outside of the sanctuary, but not in the sanctuary. Even I have my limits. I love this. I love this dialogue between Moses and God. I love it that the writer of this story was willing to put words into God's mouth and was willing to put words into Moses' mouth. Now you gotta trust there was no one there. There was no recording. This is the story this writer wants you to hear. And it's a story that suggests that we are, in fact, looking at God in our own image. And isn't that a good thing? Isn't it good that we're able to see this being, this source of all life, that from which and to which all that is flows, the ground of our being, the ultimate concern, as someone we can argue with, and someone who isn't going to go away when we argue with them? He does say to Moses, get out of here. Get out of my face. I want to brood for a while. But Moses doesn't help. And what does Moses do in response? This is so good. What's he doing? He says, so God, you know, you probably heard what the Egyptians were saying. You just took the people out of Egypt to kill them in the desert. That's it. You want those people to be saying that about you? Really, God? You want to turn your back on the covenant you made with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and Israel? You want to do that?